It's Professor Dave. Let's learn how to do long division.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
After we learned about the concept of multiplication, we had to learn how to multiply not just small numbers together, but also large ones. And we saw some different strategies for how to do this. The same goes for division. Sometimes it's easy to divide two numbers. 12 divided by 3 is clearly 4, since 4 goes into 12 three times. But what about 624 divided by 3? Just as there is an algorithm for the multiplication of large numbers, there is one for division as well, and it is called long division. This technique is usually remembered with great disdain from childhood, but if we look carefully, we can see the elegance of this technique and appreciate the patterns that it reveals. It works just like our multiplication method, simply in reverse. Instead of multiplying one number through the units place of another number, then the tens place, and so forth, we will divide one number by another, starting with the largest place value of the larger number, and then the next largest, and so forth, moving down until we get to the units place. Let's try this with the example we mentioned. We place the first number, the dividend, inside this symbol here, and the other number, the divisor, goes to the left. Now we just go through the dividend one number at a time. 3 goes into 6 two times, or in other words, 6 divided by 3 is 2. So we put a 2 here in the hundreds place of the quotient. Now we do 2 times 3, which is 6, place that directly under the first 6, and then subtract. 6 minus 6 is 0, so we draw a line and write a 0 here. Then we drop the next digit down and repeat the process. The next digit is a 2. 3 does not fit into 2, or rather, 2 divided by 3 is less than 1. So let's put a 0 here. 0 times 3 is 0. 2 minus 0 is 2, and then we drop down the 5. 3 fits into 25 a little more than 8 times, because 3 times 8 is 24. So let's put an 8 here. Then 8 times 3 is 24, as we said, and subtracting from 25, we get 1. Now there are no more digits to drop down, and 3 doesn't fit into 1, so this is called the remainder. 3 fits into 625 208 times, with 1 left over, or we can say that 625 divided by 3 is 208 remainder 1. So that's all there is to long division. We go one digit at a time, just like we did with multiplication, except we go left to right instead of right to left, since division is meant to be the reverse of multiplication. Let's try one more for practice. 397 divided by 11. This time we have to divide by a two-digit number. 11 doesn't fit into 3, so let's put a 0, get a 0 down here, which leaves us with 3. Then we bring down the 9. 11 does fit into 39 three times, so we put a 3, multiply to get 33, subtract to get 6, and then pull down the 7. 11 fits into 67 six times, so we put a 6, multiply to get 66, and subtract to get 1. 11 doesn't fit into 1, and we've run out of digits in the dividend, so that will be 36 with a remainder of 1. If we don't like these remainders, we could keep going to get decimal places. Just put a decimal here and add a 0. Drop it down to get 10. 11 doesn't fit in 10, so we put a 0, multiply to get 0, and subtract to get 10. Then we pull down another 0, and we get 100. 11 fits into 100 9 times, so we place the 9, multiply to get 99, and subtract to get 1. We would soon find out that this process could go on forever, giving alternating zeros and nines forever. And this is our first introduction to repeating decimals, which will come back later when we look at the difference between rational and irrational numbers. For now, let's check comprehension.
Thank you.
Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.